Welcome to Grab and Go Info. Power analysis is a statistical analysis based on significance level, effect size, statistical power, and sample size. We can use it to calculate any one of the four values given the other three. Power analysis and sample size calculation are common interview questions for data analyst, data scientist, and machine learning engineer positions. In this tutorial, we will cover: what are significance level, effect size, statistical power, and sample size? How to calculate the sample size for hypothesis testing using Python? How to calculate the statistical power? How to calculate the minimum detectable effect size? How to calculate the significance level? And how do sample size, significance level, and effect size impact the statistical power? Let's get started. Power analysis is commonly used for sample size calculations in hypothesis testing. This step will talk about the four components of power analysis: significance level, effect size, statistical power, and sample size. Significance level is also called alpha. It is the probability of rejecting the null hypothesis when it is true. Alpha tells us about the false positive rate or type 1 error. A commonly used alpha value is 0.05. Effect size is the magnitude of the difference between the null hypothesis and alternative hypothesis. Other factors being the same, we need a larger sample size to detect a smaller effect size. The more significant effect size is, the less likely the difference between treatment and control is due to random error. Conversely, when there is more variability in the dataset, the difference is more likely due to random error. Cohen's D measures the distance between the mean of treatment and control group while considering the standard deviation. Usually, the Cohen's D value of 0.2 is considered to be a small effect size, 0.5 a medium effect size, and 0.8 a large effect size. The effect size needs to be meaningful from a business perspective. Statistical power is the probability of correctly rejecting the null hypothesis. Or we can say it's the probability of detecting an effect if it exists. Power equals 1 minus beta, where beta is the false negative rate or type 2 error. 0.8 is a commonly used value for power. Sample size is the minimum sample size needed per group. In the first step, we will import libraries for the power analysis. NumPy is for data calculation. T-test in power is imported from stats models for power analysis of a two-sample independent t-test. Matplotlib is for visualization. In step 2, we will calculate the sample size needed for a two-sample t-test. To calculate the sample size, we need to provide effect size, alpha, and power values. Effect size refers to the standardized effect size. The difference between the treatment and control group mean is divided by the pooled standard deviation. The effect size value needs to be a positive number. We use the value 0.2 for the effect size, which is a small effect size value. Alpha is the significance level, and power is the statistical power. We use the commonly used value of 0.05 for alpha and 0.8 for power. We are doing a two-sided hypothesis testing, so alternative equals two-sided. The power analysis gave us a sample size of 393. That means we need at least 393 samples in each A/B testing group to detect a slight difference with 80% power and a 5% significance level. In step 3, we will calculate the power using effect size, significance level, and sample size. We use the sample size 393, which was calculated from the previous step, for the power calculation. Ratio equals 1 means the number of samples in the control and treatment groups are the same. We get the power of 0.8, which is consistent with the previous results in the sample size calculation. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. Tell me what tutorial you would like to watch in the comment. The next video may be based on your request. There are different ways of calculating effect size. Cohen's D is one of the most widely used methods for effect size calculation. In step 4, we will calculate effect size using Cohen's D's equation. Cohen's D's equation needs the mean, standard deviation, and sample sizes for the treatment and control group. It first calculates the pooled standard deviation and then uses the mean difference divided by the pooled standard deviation. We get the effect size of 0.27, which is a relatively small Cohen's D value. In step 5, we will calculate the significance level given the other three values. We get a significance level of 0.05, which is consistent with the previous results. In step 6, we will examine how statistical power changes with sample size changes. DepVar specifies the measure for the x-axis. DepVar equals knobs means that we are using sample size as x-axis and power as the y-axis. Knobs is the value of sample size. We use the value of 5 to 800 to plot the graph. Effect size is the effect size value for the power analysis. We use the widely used Cohen's D value for small, medium, and large effect sizes. Each effect size has one curve on the graph. Alpha is the significance level. We used 0.05 for this plot. From the graph, we can see that statistical power increases with the sample size. To achieve the same statistical power, we need more samples to detect a smaller effect size. In step 7, we will examine how statistical power changes with effect size. The effect size is used as x-axis. We plot the curves for three sample sizes, 50, 100, and 500. From the graph, we can see that statistical power increases with effect size. When the effect size is small, a larger sample size is needed to achieve a good power value. As effect size increases, the impact of sample size on power is smaller. In step 8, we will examine how statistical power changes with the significance level. Alpha is used as the x-axis. We plot the curves for the alpha range from 0.01 to 0.30. The effect size is fixed at 0.5. From the graph, we can see that statistical power increases with significance level. When alpha is small, a larger sample size is needed to achieve a good power value. As alpha increases, the impact of sample size on power is smaller. In this tutorial, we talked about how to use statistical power analysis for hypothesis testing. The method can be used to calculate the minimum sample size needed for A/B testing. We covered what are significance level, effect size, statistical power, and sample size. How to calculate the sample size for hypothesis testing using Python. How to calculate the statistical power. How to calculate the minimum detectable effect size. How to calculate the significance level. And how do sample size, significance level, and effect size impact the statistical power? If you prefer the written version of the tutorial, please check out my blog post. I will put the link in the video description. This is the blog post for this tutorial. It has all the screenshots and explanations in the video. To learn more about data science and machine learning, please subscribe to the channel and check out my YouTube playlist. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.